So we're here in Prineville, Oregon, and we're about to do the Ochoco Overlander, and it's hosted and it starts here at Good Bike Co. So James, the shop owner, unfortunately, he's running around like crazy trying to get things ready. I'm gonna just walk you guys through the shop, and then we're gonna talk about our setups for the Ochoco Overlander. First thing to notice is you'll look at the architecture, and it actually used to be an old filling station, so it's cool to see it purposefully reused into a bike shop. So this is the inside of the shop, workspaces, that's Colin over there, and Jeff, Colin, Jeff. One cool thing about this bike shop is they've got some tasty beverages, so if you just wanna hang out and grab a brew before or after, or probably after a ride, you can do that. Nice selection of supple tires. Looks like lots of local stuff. Barley Browns is in Baker City. So cool, so local beverages to enjoy. And I think this is one of my favorite parts about the shop is their kind of map adventure room. So let's take a look in here. So they've got lots of great laminated maps of the area for different rides you can do, mountain biking, gravel, bike touring, bike packing, whatever. And this whole room is filled with all your, with all the adventure gear you could ever want. So racks, handlebar bags, they've got some Randy Joe bartenders, handlebar bags, frame bags. So if you need to get kitted out for your bike adventure, you can find it here at Good Bike Co. Enough about the shop, we're gonna show you guys our particular setups for the Ochoco Overlander.
So, Ochoco Overlander, what is it? It is a 4-day, semi-supported bikepacking ride trip through the Ochoco Mountains. It's about 220 miles, close to 17,000 feet of elevation gain, so a lot of climbing. And that whole semi-supported thing means that we're responsible for carrying most of our stuff, but we don't have to worry about the cooking because there will be fully catered breakfast and dinner at camp and lunch stops along the way. What do I have on my bike? I am riding my Salsa Cutthroat, pretty much set up the same way it was for Dirty Kanza, but I did change my saddle to be more touring friendly because I will not be going fast on this ride. Up front, I have pretty much the same setup as I had for our Jack Saloon trip. It's a Salsa Anything cradle, and in the dry bag, I have my sleeping bag and pillow. Have a couple of bags on the frame here that are mostly for snacks, first aid kit, water filter, that kind of thing, phone, etc. And in the back, this is basically my junk bag. It's got some clothes, extra puffy, spare tube. I think there's a bag of jerky back in there. Kind of a random hodgepodge back in there. And what's nice about this trip is that we also get one small little drop bag. So my camp clothes, my Crocs, and some extra food, extra snacks are in that little backpack that I will drop tomorrow.
For me, I too am riding a Salsa Cutthroat. I changed it a little bit from Dirty Kanza, put on a smaller chain ring from the stock 38 to the 34. The route has a lot of climbing. I'm actually frightened of all the climbing it has. In terms of bags, I'm using the Ortlieb handlebar roll. And in there, I've got my sleeping bag, my sleeping pad, my camp pillow. In the accessory pouch, I've got a water filter, long-fingered gloves, some quick layers to get into, like a buff and a jacket and everything. And in this Ovea Negra stem bag, I'm actually carrying a camera, my little point-and-shoot to shoot B-roll. In the top two bag, this is like the media area. I've got two GoPros in there, GoPro Hero 5 with my mic hack, and a session. So you can tell, lots of camera gear for this trip for me. In the frame bag, it's this is the snack bag. So jerky, honey stingers, all sorts of bars and what have you. And for this trip, I'm carrying the shelter. So I've got this tarp tent tube bag that's got the tent poles and tent stakes. And in the rear, in the seat bag, it's got our tent, which is the tarp tent double rainbow. Other extra layers that I might need on a ride. So I've got a puffy. I think I've got another kind of soft shell in case it gets really cold. The weather forecast, not looking awesome. We're going to be in elevation, so there might be snow. So we really have to be prepared for all the eventualities. So that's it for this quick tour of Good Bike Co, as well as a kind of a nerd out on the gear that we're carrying. Next couple days are going to be hard. I'm not going to lie. Are you ready?
No, but I don't know that you can't be ready.
Right. It's a lot of climbing. We've been busy with some shoots this week, so I haven't had too much time to train. But we're going to film this event, this experience, and share it with you guys. So yeah, look for that video soon. Don't forget to subscribe. And as always, keep the supple side down.